This is the Duos SMP. This is where two people get paired together and they have to fight against all of the other duos. Here you can see me working on a humble little home. My partner is Dr. Funk, and he won't be in this video much, as I don't actually meet up with him for a while. I'm actually pretty powerful on the SMP at the moment, because not only am I in the zombie pigman gang, but my partner Dr. Funk is also a pretty strong ally of the Joyous Bus. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and remember to like and subscribe. So, I was in a Google Meet with Dr. Funk, and he and Joyous Bus were discussing how they wanted to make themselves their own base. Meanwhile, I was working on my base, which was a bit awkward. But now, I've got to introduce you into the most important part of this entire SMP. This. I like to call the sacred birch boat. If anything happens to this, I will be in absolute devastation. So if there is one goal I have, it's to make sure that that birch does not die. The hard part about this new base is that I don't want it too close from spawn because my old base got the coordinates leaked, which was pretty annoying because it was way too close to base, which is why you could see me traveling as far away as possible. Now, progress on my base is going pretty well. I've placed down a chest, furnace and crafting table, and I've decided on its main gimmick. It's gonna be a ditch. I know, hilarious. Then night strikes, and I am absolutely terrified. I place down my boat and try to cover myself up as I hear spider noises. I'm only on one heart, and I do not want to have to reset again. So, as you can see here, I'm just trying to get myself into position. Now, as you can see, people are starting to sleep, but there's one problem. I don't have enough wool to make a bed, which is the main problem with this base. So I start trying to cover up the boat so I can stay there for the night. Tensity is really getting to me here, and I'm messing up, and okay, I'm not really that scared, but you get the idea. And then I finally manage to barricade myself up and get in the boat for the night. But I get bored pretty quickly, so I start mining. What I'm hoping to get is iron or coal, because torches would be really appreciated. Unfortunately, I don't really get any luck here, aside from maybe a few copper. But then, it hits me. What if I made a mine? Yes, that would be very useful. It's a common thing most people do, but for some reason, I didn't really get the idea to do it. And now, it's finally done. Beautiful, I know. After a bit of confusing with the sleeping cycle, finally day. I managed to kill a sheep, which was amazing, because not only could I gain health from the meat, but I was one step closer to making that glorious bed. But then, disaster strikes, as I die off camera. Then it's nighttime again, and everyone, including me, who hasn't got a bed, has to leave and rejoin. It was pretty simple. But then, something interesting happens. Now, as all of this has been happening, I've still been in a Google Meet with Dr. Funk and Joyous Bus. And all they've really been talking about is how I should go to their epic mineshaft base, which I refuse to do, because I want to live in my humble little home. Now, apparently, Dr. Funk has somehow managed to find Dr. Donut the First's base. And that's pretty interesting, because apparently Dr. Donut the First is really stacked with lots of iron. Now, I'm not sure about the specific interactions, but what I do know is somehow Dr. Funk managed to get away with sleeping in Dr. Donut the First's base. Now, this is where I made a pretty big mistake. I thought it was only me and Dr. Funk online, because it seemed like everyone else had left because of the sleeping thing. But I was wrong. Turned out everyone was on the server, and it led to this conversation.
Hi.
You just raided Dr. Donut's base. Lol.
I didn't raid it. I found it. Not yet. Bye, Donut.
Okay.
Anyway, today was resource gathering time, and here are some of the highlights. So, I got more wood for my base, which is pretty important, but I also got the last piece of wool required to get a bed. This was really awesome because I did it fine. I didn't have to rejoin and my bed was going to look good. So I had to get some flowers. Luckily, I managed to get some pink dye and my bed was going to look beautiful. I'm just going to show you some mobs I found in the background while I talk. But this is the interesting part. Dr. Donut asked Dr. Funk if he could join our team. Now, we don't want this, but we were suspicious. That's why we thought maybe he was working as a spy, because he is known to do that in some Minecraft servers, and maybe Iron Fist hired him to get information. So we declined it. But yeah, that's all I really have to say about that. But all good things must come to an end, as I was finally convinced to go to the new Mineshaft base, which meant I had to say goodbye to my cozy home. Rest in peace, you will be missed. But while I was travelling, I noticed something interesting. Joyous Bus's partner had finally joined, and I don't know what to make of this username. I think I'm going to have to blow it out, but I'll just call him by his numbers. So he joined, and I'll tell you what happened next. I finally made it to Joyous Bus's and Dr. Funk's base. Now, I kind of regret coming here, because not only is the base really ugly compared to my humble little home, but they also want to separate me and Dr. Funk as much as possible from Joyous Bus and the other one. In fact, I think for the rest of the entire SMP, I'm just going to call him the other one. Now, as you can see here, there was actually a bed at the base waiting for me, but that didn't stop me from crafting my own. And with that, I finally met up with my partner, Dr. Funk. Took you long enough, buddy. And with Joyous Bus and the other one arriving, I think that's a pretty good time to end the video. It was certainly a rocky start with ups and downs, and this is only 7 minutes of an hour-long gameplay. Massive shout out to the other one for making editing this bit a nightmare. And with all that being said, I only had one thing left to do. Punch Joyous Bus into the lake. See you guys in the next one.